Welcome to my channel. I'm Sharon. Today is Fun Friday, so let's see how much fun we'll have today. Today we're diving deep. We're talking about intuition. That's something Hollywood call it the it factor. It is what you have. We all have it innately. It can be developed more. Children have it naturally. They have a wonderful human imagination. They're always pretending they're hearing and seeing, and they probably are hearing and seeing things because they come directly from God. They still have that innocence, that purity, that unadulterated, unaltered essence about them. And the same with the Ten Commandments, that thou shalt not commit adultery, which is really what that Ten Commandments is saying. You're keeping yourself pure, unadulterated, no other religion, no other God. You're not idolizing even a formation of a God within you. You are receiving everything in the moment, in the present moment. You are present with yourself, present with God. It is awesome. It's like being with your best friend you haven't seen in months, weeks, years, perhaps, and you just want to sit there and take it all in at that time. So let's look at Psalms 89:7. That is talking about reverence, having reverence, honor, respect for Christ's consciousness, for that God-given ability that you have to have intuition. And intuition is simply a nod from God saying, hey, how are you? Here's a little assignment that I'm giving you, an answer to your question. Are you ready to receive it, to do something with it? If not, the intuition is gonna come again. If you have a question or a problem, you're looking for an answer to, I find it's really helpful before I go to bed. I just say, I know the answer. God knows the answer. And when I awaken, the answer will come. John 89:7. Psalms 89:7. All will be listed in the description box below. So when we're really having an intuition. Intuition is very powerful. Don't ignore your intuition. Don't ignore the prompting from God that is guiding you. Intuition is simply within. And some people can naturally do it without training or very little training. This is what they are naturally do. Some zodiac signs can do it very easily. But minus the zodiac sign, some people can really connect with their inner being very easily, very succinctly, and very powerfully. And that is what we want you to do. This is another tool that God has given you to use to empower you. We are in the age of Aquarius. Piscean age is over. Everything has been dismantled from the top-down leadership and built up. This is your opportunity to get in there and start building using your intuition. If you have an idea to create a business, create your business. There are so many online tools to help and entice you and to excite you to the next level of e-commerce. So choose those ideas that really excite you. So you can have zeal. Like in John 6:27, it talks about having zeal, that when Christ went into the temple, the merchants were selling things in the church. Of course, Christ got very upset. That was zealous. Christ was very passionate about not selling in the temple. Everything was dismantled. The table was cleared of all merchandise that the merchants was trying to sell. So there is an order to things, and we have to find that order and follow that order. The universe has laws. When we need assistance, we call upon the name of the Lord and we shall be saved. And we're calling upon the universal law. The universal law of help, of prosperity, abundance, the law of attraction, which is the most popular, the law of reciprocity. So we have to be mindful of those when we're doing our creating and manifesting. So let's look at John 10:10, where it talks about and having an abundant life. Yes, this is one of the laws, the law of abundance and prosperity. These laws were given to us to create and manifest our wonderful, beautiful life and have an awesome human imagination, to develop communities, to rise above the low level thinking and have a higher level of thinking. This is your time to open yourself up to the universe, to receive that intuition, that internal knowing. And also, intuition can be looked upon as kind of internal payment, because you are paying the price of sitting there. Like when you go to college, you have a tuition that you have to come out of your pocket and pay. And here, intuition, the payment, the money is coming into you. The knowledge is coming into you, and therefore it will flow out so all of us can enjoy your wonderful creation from your wonderful human imagination. Say what? Yeah, your wonderful human imagination. I just love the intuition. Some people are mesmerized by it, but we all have it and we can develop it. The Bible gives us instructions. Nature has a beautiful intuitiveness, just sitting and meditating. But let's clear out the word meditation, because it is a heavy word for many. And simply sit. You can sit in quiet and see what comes up. Will your question be answered? Pose a question to yourself, to your intuition, and ask the intuition to answer the question. Give it a few minutes, a moment, and see what comes up. It may even come up when you're washing dishes. It may come up when you're driving to work or to the grocery store. It may even come up, I know, when you're in the shower. A lot of great ideas have come to me in shower. So, intuition is very powerful. It's an in-knowing. It's God speaking to you, giving you what you need at that time to move forward, to go to the next right step and the next right step. That is your intuition. It's a hunch. I got a feeling, a question that I needed answered. And then a person name came up. And I thought about that person name and what they did or used to do. Yes, intuition gave me the answer. I had no idea about that, but it was in me. That is the thing. The answers are within you. Are you ready to move forward on your answers? Are you ready to close the deal? Are you ready to close the deal? Are you ready to close the deal? To get in there and follow your hunch? It takes courage to follow your intuition. It takes determination, focus, above all and with all, love. It takes love, passion, and even better word I got for you is zeal. You gotta be zealous. zealous, zealot, as the Bible would say. You have to be so passionate, it becomes all consuming. That I know, that I know, that I know this is what I'm supposed to do. And my intuition, my tuition, intuition, your internal knowing, your internal payment, your internal money system is giving you confirmation. And you really don't need confirmation from someone on the outside. It's nice to have it. And if the universe see that you really need the confirmation, it may come from another person, a conversation you overhear, TV, a sign, actual physical sign. I've even had those to happen. But intuition is so powerful. I knew at the age of 12 I was going to be a doctor. No doubt about it. It was so strong, so palpable, and it led me every step of the way to the next right step, to the school, to the people, the financing. It led me to everything. And here I am now, talking in front of YouTube. Who knew? And also I have a website, a clinic website, and my poetry website in the description below for you to enjoy. John 10:10, abundant life. We have Psalms 89:7, reverence for all life, all respect, because God is in everything, every little thing that we do. And when we honor and give God respect, ourselves respect, like any father, earthly father, and your heavenly father, you become irresistible. They want to give you everything, everything your heart's desire. Looking at John 6:27, being zealous. Have a great passion. Have a massive, explosive passion, and the world will be at your feet. I'm Sharon. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe my channel. Share it with your friends. This is powerful information, intuition. There it is. There's great love for you here. And until next time, we'll see you on